Up first, Kamala Harris on the campaign trail this Labor Day weekend after her first interview since becoming the Democratic nominee. And while she cleared the hurdle without any major fumbles, some critics say it wasn't enough.
I think people are ready to turn the page on that.
Kamala Harris billing herself as the candidate of change and answering questions for the first time in this campaign about some of her reversals on progressive policy, like a ban on fracking.
My values have not changed. What I have seen is that we can grow and we can increase a thriving clean energy economy without banning fracking.
She gave a similar answer, defending her flip on illegal immigration from 2019.
You raised your hand when asked whether or not the border should be decriminalized. Do you still believe that?
I believe there should be consequence. We have laws. My value around what we need to do to secure our border. That value has not changed.
Donald Trump quickly weighed in, saying the interview confirmed Harris's far-left values and her status as a flip-flopper.
She probably goes back to her room and gets sick to her stomach when she says what she has to say because she's a Marxist.
But Harris making clear she doesn't want to be drawn into a food fight with Trump over race or gender.
He suggested that you happened to turn black recently for political purposes.
Same old tired playbook. Next question, please.
Here with me today, podcaster, journalist, and author Kara Swisher, conservative pollster and New York Times opinion writer Kristen Soltis Anderson, New York Times journalist and host of the Interview podcast, Lulo Garcia Navarro, and National Review editor-in-chief Rich Lowry. Welcome, everyone, especially Rich, who's a first-timer.
Thank you. I'll try not to disappoint.
Okay. We'll have a good time. Kara, did Harris do what she needed to do in the interview?
Well, she's got to do a lot of interviews, I think. I think it was fine. There were no fumbles. And she answered relatively well. She seemed, you know, calm. She was quite calm. She foisted off a bunch of questions that were about the past, and I thought she did that pretty well. I don't think it did any damage, no harm, no foul kind of interview.
Did it do her any good?
It didn't need to necessarily. She needs to do a lot of them. I think she should do local ones. I think she should do them all over the place. But it, yeah, because it didn't do her bad. That's why, because it was fine.
Kristen, do you agree with Kara that she did fine?
Fine is probably the right word. It's clear that she is really committing to this pivot to the center. The whole time I kept thinking about that kerfluffle in 2012 when Mitt Romney was going from the primary to the general and his campaign said, oh, it's like an Etch-a-Sketch. We're just going to flip it over, shake it, and it'll erase everything. It's like she's trying to erase the last time she ran in a primary and say, no, no, I'm different. And it may work. The two things, though, that she said in this interview that I can easily imagine Mar-a-Lago high command finding useful. One was she said, you know, we needed to recover as an economy, and we've done that. A lot of Americans don't think we've recovered as an economy. She used that as a justification for why her positions had changed. The second thing she said repeatedly was, my values have not changed. And given that she has had some positions in the past that were pretty progressive, I imagine that could be viewed as a gift for Republicans.
Well, I want to pick up on that because shortly after CNN released the first clip from the interview, the Trump campaign put together this ad of some of Harris's greatest hits from her 2019 campaign.
My values have not changed.
Reduce red meat specifically.
Yes.
The Boston Marathon bomber. They should be able to vote.
I think we should have that conversation.
Abolish ICE.
Yeah. Would you ban offshore drilling?
Yes. I'm in favor of banning fracking.
I am prepared to pass a Green New Deal.
Rich, does my values have not changed address her problem with flip-flops when she was running as a lefty in 2019 worried about Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren?
No. I mean, it could be part of a cogent explanation of these things, but in the interview, she said that line, which clearly had been fed to her, but didn't really connect to anything. She didn't explain any of these changes of point of view. And I'm not against people changing their minds. It's, you know, George McGovern changed his mind on regulations, but it's because he started a small business and he realized how burdensome it is. So there was something going on there besides just changing on 8 or 10 things instantly in the course of a couple weeks, mostly still just explained via staff rather than with the candidate's own words. So this was a replacement level interview. It was not terrible, but it was not impressive. And if I were the campaign, my takeaway would be, yeah, do more interviews. But local, you know, 5-minute pull-aside interviews do not put her in a setting where she might be significantly and in a sustained way challenged for 20 minutes because I think she'd wilt under that pressure.
Lulu, well, first of all, what do you think of what Rich just said?
Yeah.
You agree?
I think she did okay. She seemed nervous, especially at the beginning. There had been so much pressure put on this interview. She waited way too long to do one, so it was like the Super Bowl. It didn't need to be. And so she did no harm. I agree with Kara, but I also agree with Rich that I don't think she did anyone any favors, and there's still a lot of questions that she needs to answer.
But let me ask you about one of those questions. If you switch from ban on fracking to no ban, if you switch from decriminalize immigration to laws have consequences and need to be enforced, how does that fit under my values haven't changed?
I think exactly. I think the thing with my values hasn't changed is that she's trying to capitalize on the thing that actually voters say they like about her, which they see her as someone with leadership, they see her as someone who has integrity, things that Donald Trump scores very poorly on. So she's trying to capitalize on that, like, trust me, believe me, I am a good person, I am a change candidate, right? But she doesn't really explain what it is that she believes in. And so I'm not so concerned about fracking. I know that that's a big deal for Pennsylvania. I think where it's going to become an issue is on the border, because decriminalizing, you know, people crossing the border illegally, there are a lot of reasons to say that that's fine because of, you know, things that are, you know, too lengthy to explain now. But it doesn't really play well to the general public in an election where the immigration really, really matters to people.
I don't think people mind people changing that. Two things. Of the people on this panel, you've interviewed her, correct? Have you interviewed
her? I have never met Kamala.
I've interviewed
Kamala
four
Harris.
Or five times. She's not going to wilt.
I'm not getting an interview, in case you're wondering.
No, I know, but she's not a wilter. She's actually quite good in interviews. And she had some bad ones, but she's like everybody else, she falls down. The second thing is, oddly enough, my family does fracking in Pennsylvania. And I asked them last night, or had been in the business, because it's a coal business. And they are Trump voters, but they were satisfied with that answer. They're like, okay, as long as she doesn't do it, that's great.
I just wonder about this all-purpose answer, my values haven't changed, when on a lot of issues, her values or her policies have changed dramatically, because she was running then on the left, and now she's running the center. I want to bring up another issue. Harris also defended the administration's record and talked about how proud she is to have served as vice president. Here's what Biden said about her at the Democratic convention.
We've had one of the most extraordinary 4 years of progress ever. When I say we, I mean Kamala and me.
Now, Harris and Biden will be together in Pittsburgh on Monday, Labor Day. Kristen, is it a mistake for Harris to campaign with Joe Biden?
I think it is. I think that in the interview, when she was asked about having worked for him, she was pretty gracious, and I think that's fine. I think having respect for the man who chose you to be his running mate is fine. But at a certain point, his job approval is very low. Voters do not like what they have seen over the last 3.5 years. She's aware of that. Dana Bash pushed her in the interview on it, and she kind of tried to say, well, don't really blame me for the last 3.5 years. If you're out there campaigning with Joe Biden, that really is continuing to tie yourself to an administration that voters are simply saying, please, 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 not.
I disagree. I think Joe Biden still has a lot of pull in certain places, places where she might need his help. I mean, he is still popular among certain cadres of white working class voters. That is his background. And so I actually don't think that it is a bad thing to be seen with the sitting president of the United States. At the end of the day, she cannot hide from it, so she might as well embrace it.
Yeah, they're doing it in Pittsburgh, and he had some residual strength even towards the end in the blue wall states. But I just still think this is a bad idea. We'll know a lot about who's going to win this election based on who wins the argument over who represents change. And if she's change, if she's something different than Trump and Biden, and she's turning the page, that's huge for her. And Trump has to push back against that.
But change from what? I mean, the thing about this is not just who's the change candidate, but what are you changing from? Do you want to change from division? Do you want to change from chaos? That is the argument that Kamala Harris is making. Yeah. And so therefore,
but
she is the change
candidate.
But if you want to change from Biden and high prices, then he's embracing that. So it's a question of who wins that argument.
Change from an administration that a lot of people think has failed and has an approval rating that's 40%, then Trump wins. So that's the argument.
All right. That is the argument, and we have a debate in a few days, I think 10 days. We'll see who wins it.